This Sunday, I promised you that you shall deal with causes, not causes, but consequences of unbelief. What does unbelief bring in our lives? What are the dangers? In fact, I would call it dangers of unbelief. Hallelujah. We have been talking about the causes of unbelief. But now we want to talk about the dangers of unbelief. And later on we can look at how do we deal with unbelief. But today allow me to look, we look at what does unbelief do in our lives? What are the dangers? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
We saw various causes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
But today, we look at what are the dangers. And we want to pray by saying, all we can receive from God, we receive through believing Him. There is nothing we can receive without believing. Because how God brings anything He wants to give us, He brings it through His Word. Everything was created through His Word. The things we see, the visible and invisible, God spoke. When they were not there, they were not existing. And God Himself trusted in His own word. God believes in His own word. When He speaks, He has confidence that His word can never fail. Are you together, somebody? And that's how God wants us to be. If God knows His word cannot fail, He wants us to believe it. And when we believe it, that word begins to work. And it began to do what God has said it will do. So believing is the avenue, is the conduit. It's the only way we have that we can receive anything from God. Even to live. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
What's the difference? People believe many things. They believe they will do this and tomorrow too they will do this. But the difference is bringing God in the picture. That you cannot do this or tomorrow without God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today I want us to be the first one. Dangers of unbelief. Hallelujah. One is unbelief is sin and makes us to depart from the living God. There are people who began by believing God, but on the way when they met challenges, they turned away from God. So unbelief itself, I said it's sin because it's refusal to be persuaded, refusal to be convicted, refusal to give God credence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
When you refuse to be persuaded by the word of God, you are refusing to be persuaded by God. When you refuse to be convicted by what the word of God is saying, then unbelief sets in. And unbelief itself is sin. I'll help you understand. Romans 14:23b. For whatever is not of faith, the word faith comes from pistis there. Meaning whatever is not of believing or persuasion or credence or conviction of the truth of God. Amen. Is sin. So we think sin is just stealing. Think it's adultery. It's lying. Man, that it is true, it is sin. But all this come with what we call unbelief. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. But know that anything which is not of faith is sin. That's why you can do the Ten Commandments, but you'll still be an ashes. Because when you break one, you have broken all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Hebrews 11, verse 6, it says, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. Hallelujah. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Without faith, you cannot please God. Without believing him. Because why is it? He says, for when you come to him, you must first believe that he exists. Hallelujah. Second, if he exists, he can do what he says he can do. He is what he says he is. No man has seen God. So it's only by believing you can have an encounter with him. And by not believing, you are saying God does not exist. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are saying what he says is not true. Now, can you see why it is becoming sin now? Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has called us to live a life of faith, a life of trusting him in his word. And he may have confidence in his ability to save us, in his ability to deliver us. We have confidence in his ability to heal us. That we have confidence in his ability to provide for us and to give us eternal life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what God requires of us. And that's why he says in Hebrews 10:8 that now the just shall live by faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We shall not live by what we see. Faith means we walk by not what we see, but what God has said. But unbelief demands we walk by sight and what we think. And how we feel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he continued to say, but if any man draw back, my soul shall not have pleasure in him. Hear what God is saying. That the just shall live by faith. But if you draw back from faith, that is now unbelief coming in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That the God shall not have pleasure in you. Glory to God.
Amen.
Because what God is saying, as he is, so he wants us to be. If he can trust his own word, who are we to distrust his word? His word has never failed. Hallelujah. He continued to say, whatever you do in word or in deed, do all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father by him. When you walk by faith, you no longer live by yourself. You live by the ability of God. You live by the strength of God. You live by the power of God. And that's what God wants us to be. And you can only do that by believing him. And with all things, whether word or deed, in the name of Jesus, and whatever you do, you do it happily, as unto the Lord, not unto men. That's in Colossians 3:17 to 23. 17 and 23. But unbelief makes us to do the opposite. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When people begin to backtrack, you find they start questioning the word of God. And that's what the devil works. When he went to Eve at the garden of Eden, the devil asked Eve, did God say hallelujah,
amen,
that when you eat this fruit you'll die? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When unbelief begins to set in, you find the same language coming to believers. You start questioning what God has said. So unbelief, it makes us to live without God. You start saying, I can do by myself. I'm talking to somebody who was doing her education in China. Hallelujah. And she began telling us, we are backward because we believe in God. Instead of having plans and having how we can solve problems, we say, God will do. We are waiting on God. I'm not saying planning is bad. Planning is very good. God himself is a planner. But when you remove God from the picture, then you fall into a danger of trusting in your own ability. And that is what unbelief does. Yeah, you go out there and find people have developed countries and they don't believe in God. We start thinking they are better off without God. But that's a lie. I think Corona can teach you that though they are so developed, they are turning to God because Corona is killing them, killing everybody, doesn't matter the level of development. Hallelujah. So unbelief makes us to live without God, and we start trusting in ourselves. And it's very dangerous. And we do things in our own name and for ourselves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In most of the wars which have been fought in these worlds, you find it has begun by a man who trusts in his ability and his army. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And begins to say he can bring a revolution. And start erasing other people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me tell you, you cannot survive without God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Living without faith in God is like a fish living out of water. I don't know how long a fish can survive out of the water. But that is how some people are trying to live their lives. So unbelief throws us out of God's presence and strangles our spiritual life and lastly our natural breath out to death. There are people who threw God out and shortened their life because it's God who protects our lives. Remember the book of Job. Satan tells God, I cannot touch Job because you build a hedge around him. We are alive because there is a hedge around us. And as Christians, even if you go through challenges, don't leave God, because you'll be destroying your own hedge. And Satan will not miss out that opportunity to strike you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Tell your neighbor, do not have an evil heart of unbelief. God does not have pleasure with people holding unbelief. In fact, the Bible tells us that in Hebrews 3:12, hallelujah, take heed, brethren, lest there be any of you with an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. God is calling a heart of unbelief an evil heart. I'll show you later that many people will go to hell not because of the many sins they have done. Hallelujah. But refusing to believe God, refusing to believe the work that Jesus finished on Calvary for them, and therefore refusing to receive the grace of God. So unbelief is sin and makes us to depart from God. Number two, unbelief makes us or brands God a liar, makes God a liar. Hallelujah. You know, there is nothing as serious as to make the one who is a truth to make him a liar. Because we know who is a liar. The devil. Satan is a liar. Jesus said he is a liar from the beginning. When he speaks a lie, he manufactures his own. Hallelujah. So when we refuse to believe God, we are saying he is a liar. What he is saying is not true. We are trying to liken him to the devil. That's how unbelief is, how serious it is. So if someone believes not, he does not believe God or his word or his works. Remember, Jesus told them, if you don't believe my words, believe the works that I do. That's what it says in John 14. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So when you don't believe God, his word, his works, or who he is, we are saying, or that person would be saying, God is not what he says he is. Hallelujah. That God is not able to do what he has said or promised. Glory to God. So when a person refuses to believe God, it means he does not believe what God has said about even that person himself. He does not believe what God has said about himself and about his son. There are people today who have not believed in the Son of God, but they believe in God, but they have denied the Lordship of Jesus Christ and his sonship. Hallelujah. They can talk about God, but don't talk about Jesus. That is unbelief. Hallelujah. Because they have refused to believe what God is saying about his son. And they are in essence saying God has lied that he has sent his son Jesus Christ on the earth. In fact, John says in the book of 1 John, I think it's 1 John 3. He says, those who do not believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and that he came in the flesh, they have the spirit of Antichrist. Hallelujah. And that's what the spirit of unbelief doubts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
You know, you can say you believe in Jesus, but you still deny his deity. That he is God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me demonstrate.
In
John 1:17. It says, for the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Jesus is the way, is the truth and life. Hallelujah. In 1 John 5:10, it says that he that believes on the Son of God, he that believeth on the Son of God has a witness in himself. When you receive Jesus, you receive witness. The Holy Spirit is a witness in your spirit. Whether people say whether you have God or you don't have God, you are born again or not, the testimony is not what people say. The testimony is what the Spirit of God says in your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
But he continued to say, he that believes not God has made him a liar. When you don't believe that, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. What? Because he believes not the record that God gave of his Son. Ushuhuda ambao Mungu ametoa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has given a testimony about his Son. And it's a testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That he has given us eternal life. And this life is in his Son. And he that has the Son has life. And he does not have the Son does not have life. What does that mean? He says, but if you don't believe this, if you don't believe this, that's what he says in verse 10. You are saying God is a liar. So everyone who is not born again and is refusing to receive the Son of God, he is refusing the testimony of God himself. That he has said you can only have eternal life through Jesus Christ. For God has given a testimony about it. That he has given us eternal life, and this life is in the Son. And he that has the Son has this life. So we can go to church, we can give offerings, we can be baptized. But the moment we deny that only by receiving Jesus you can have eternal life, we cancel every faith that we have. Because we brought God a liar. And let me tell you, the judgment shall be great. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
You cannot call God a liar. Because in the final day, you'll find you don't have that eternal life. Because unbelief will make you not to receive Jesus. Are we together somebody?
Amen.
Sometimes we don't believe what God has said concerning ourselves. And that's why many people are suffering. God has said many things concerning his people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But sometimes we don't believe it. We want to believe many things God has said. But there are things he has spoken about you for your good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when you don't receive it, then we live a life of affliction. Glory to God.
Amen.
There are many Christians today who are living an afflicted life. Sorrow, grief, pain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yet God has provided for us a way out. Let's read Isaiah 53:4. It says, surely he has borne our griefs. He has carried our griefs. The word grief there, it is from a Greek word holy. Holy. No, it's a Greek word, holy. Nasema holy. Amen. Which means sickness, disease, maladi, calamity. Hallelujah. So he said he has borne or he has carried our sicknesses. He has carried our diseases. He carried our calamities. And he continued to say, and he carried our sorrows. Sorrows means makoba. In Greek, it says makoba. Means affliction, pain, anguish. So if I may read the whole scripture, it says, surely he has borne our diseases and sicknesses and has carried our affliction, pain, and anguish. Yet we did esteem him stricken and smitten of God. Today, we can receive our healing. Today, we can get peace. Today, we can walk in good health. But we can still find people walking still afflicted. They would rather believe more in what they can see. What the doctors are saying than what God is saying. You tell them, you are saying you have malaria, God can remove malaria. Then he said, no, the doctor said that I'll die within 3 days. Hallelujah. Amen. The doctor said, only this medicine. Only this medicine can heal me. Yet you have been taking that medicine for the last 6 months. And there's no change. You can turn and believe God. Put that friend called unbelief down. Hallelujah. And get another friend called believing God. And you'll see what will happen in your life. When you don't believe God, and we don't trust him, hallelujah, that he can heal us or save us or bless us, we are saying what he has written and all the testimonies he has given in this book that he is a healer, that is, they are saying it's fake. Hallelujah. But listen, God is not a man that he may lie. He is not a son of man that he may change his mind. Hallelujah. He is not a son of man that may change his mind. Has he said it? He shall do it. Has he spoken it? He shall make it good. Hallelujah. And all he needs you to do is to trust in him. Trust what he has said. Because believing is trusting. Whether you don't see it, that you know he'll do it. The same way when you receive salvation, you didn't see it. When he says, Jesus, I'm a sinner, forgive me. You never saw it in your eye, you are seen being removed. When you told him, come into my heart. Hallelujah. Amen. You never saw him coming in. But you believed in your heart. And you confessed with your mouth. And you got born again. Hallelujah. Amen. That's how it is about receiving anything from God. And when you said you are born again, we started seeing transformation. We start showing you no longer drink, you are no longer drunkard. You stop other relationships which you are adulterous. You even stop going certain places. You stop lying. Some of us began to be very, very smart. Manifestation began. The things you could not stop, you are able to stop. But you did not see anything happening when you were believing. As I hold up to that place, as I stop there, and the second, as I will be going to the third one, I want to tell you, turn from unbelief. Because unbelief will make many people to perish. And it's also making many not to receive what God has said. The same way we believed when we were receiving salvation, is the same way we can believe what God has said about us. Many people have been unable to get healing because of unbelief. But God is ready to heal. Healing is already given to you. Turn from unbelief. Let's close there for this session. We are going to the next session. God bless you. And you shall be looking at the third one in the next session. So watch all the parts, part one and part two. God bless you. And see you in the next session. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.